Fortunately, there is a defensive turret that will help you resist monster attacks. It is extremely effective, if I do say so myself. And I would know. I created it.
Yeah, yeah, open a window. Your ego's stinking up the place. Listen, kid, if you encounter any materials scattered around out there, no matter how junky they seem, bring them to us. We'll help you find a use for them.
Automatically attack. Just don't put the turret outside the defensive umbrella. They can't stand the storm. Listen to me carefully. At night, the bases will attract no end of dangerous creatures. If it is destroyed, we'll be torn to pieces by the storm in seconds.
Bastards are here, guns are loaded. Let's get this started.
Finally, the transmission device is almost repaired. You better collect more supplies and meet back here before nightfall so we can prepare. I've sent the salvage we've gathered from several scattered vehicles your way. Use it wisely. Running vehicles are rare commodities. And should you happen to use one, exercise caution. The ether storm paralyzes motors when night falls, because, of course they do. Almost there. When the etheric energy is raging at night, it should be able to provide enough energy to help us reopen the portal. As for you, I'm afraid if you don't make it back on time, we won't wait for you. Don't let poor punctuality be your downfall. seem like an honest, if simple-minded, sort of person. So do enjoy. Today, I will provide you with more defensive turrets. In addition, I'll send you through my latest turret design. You may look over the blueprints for more details. Upgrading the original turret should help it adore more of those creatures.
Not be stingy with bullets either. Let them rain down like hellfire.
Is completed. Energy devices are being accumulated to protect the base, but we are ready to go home.
Airdrop has been delivered.
What the hell, Doc? We teleported, but we're still in the same damn place.
Do you think I don't know that, Dead Sea? The energy in this space is too strong. It's sucking us in place like candy. We need to harness more of that energy ourselves to break through this barrier.
I see broken clock kicks on.
Get ready, soldier. It's gonna be a big one.
The teleportation device needs more work. The etheric energy is going to attract more enemies in the meantime, so I built more turrets for you to use and upgrade as the materials gathered. Don't make a bigger mess of this. Based on my observations throughout these last 2 days, the ether crystals release a large burst of energy out of the storms, cause them to grow reactive at night. They're quite unstable in their current state, but if we could manage to control that during the daytime, we might be able to use their energy.
I'll mark the locations of a few crystals on the map. Don't exactly get how you think you can control them while making them go nuts, though.
Take this. Device that would cause a reaction within the ether crystals. Use it when in close proximity and smash them. Then you'll be able to gather the pure crystallized energy that's released. Or it will resemble several frag grenades blowing up in your face. Certainly one of those things. I have no idea what you're talking about, Dempsey. Now hurry! Smash the ether crystals!
Listen, the base has its own warehouse that can be used for storage. That warehouse also lets you share supplies with your teammates. Trust me, this is not the time to be a lone wolf.
Thank you. might as well get back to gathering supplies for tonight's storm. Can you even fathom the energy it takes to transport you back? Be serious, or focus on your task! Towers had been unlocked as well, so make good use of them.
Let's give the meatbags everything we got.
Everybody wins. Well, save for the disgusting creatures of this world, but they're motherless cretins anyway. Handle those ores with care now. We need to be able to exploit as much ether as we can. It is precious. Before we leave, you can still complete the regular tasks from our team and collect more ores. I wish you luck.